Bomber, you're hurt.
I still live. And you?
A slight wound, crack on the head. Out for hours. What happened?
We won.
Bomber gone, too.
Of our original 13, how many are left?
7.
And Thorin?
Soon there will be only 6. I have brought him.
Farewell, good thief. I wish to part in friendship and would take back my words at the gate.
There are many words I would take back also.
And does it take this to make us see each other?
Thorin.
Hush. You are no coward, my friend. I am sorry I so named you.
This is not important.
And I was wrong. You did understand war. It was I who did not. Until now.
Farewell, King Under the Mountain.
Child of the kindly West, I have come to know if more of us valued your ways, food and cheer above hoarded gold, it would be a merrier world. But sad or merry, I must leave it now. Farewell.
Farewell, Thorin.
You take only 2 tiny bags of gold home with you? Your share was greater.
It's all my pony could carry, and it's more than I'll ever need.
But you have other prizes.
The ring? Oh, yes. I'll keep it as a souvenir, in a glass box on the mantle.
Ha! And so the prophecies of old have come true. Smaug is gone, and the goblins driven away. The dwarves and elves live in peace, and the men thrive, multiply, and build a civilization.
Prophecies.
What?
I had a hand in all that.
Surely you don't disbelieve the prophecies because you helped bring them about. You don't really suppose, do you, that all your adventures and escapes were managed by mere luck, just for your sole benefit? You're a very fine person, Mr. Baggins, and I'm very fond of you. But you're only quite a little fellow in a wide world, after all.
Thank goodness.
Yes, you'll return to your home. Place your souvenir ring on your mantle. Publish your story, which you believe has come to its end.
What do you mean, believe it has come to an end? It has, hasn't it?
Oh, Bilbo Baggins, if you really understood that ring, someday members of your family not yet born will, then you'd realize that this story has not ended, but is only beginning.